Hi students, today we are going to see the same concept, concept number 5, sum number 11. Find the area of the shaded region. Find the area of the shaded region. So completely fully shaded, right? So what are shapes we are having? We are having a semicircle, right? Semicircle and small semicircle and small semicircle, right? We are having three semicircles, right? One is nothing but bigger semicircle. The remaining two are, I think so, same semicircles, right? So area of, so we want to find the area of shaded region. It's nothing but area of bigger semicircle plus two times of area of smaller semicircle, right? So given, so first what are things we are having? We are having semicircle, two kinds of semicircle. One is nothing but bigger semicircle, another one is nothing but smaller semicircles, right? Bigger semicircle and smaller semicircles. So you can write it as bigger, right? Bigger semicircle, right? Bigger semicircle and smaller semicircle, right? Semicircle. So for bigger semicircle, for finding the area of a circle, right? Semicircle, what is the formula? Pi r square divided by 2. So r alone is needed, right? So they have given the radius, right? So see that AO is nothing but center point for the, O is a center point for this bigger semicircle, right? So AO is nothing but 14 centimeter. AO is nothing but 14 centimeter. So OA or AO, OA is equal to 14 centimeter. Here OA is nothing but radius. So radius of bigger semicircle is equal to 14 centimeter. And for smaller semicercle, right, O dash, right? O dash is nothing but center point for OA, right? O. So from O to this measurement is nothing but 7 centimeter, and this is nothing but radius for smaller semicircle, right? Radius for smaller semicircle. So see here we are having different radius. So I'm just taking as capital R and small r, or R1 and R2, right? So R2 is nothing but radius of a smaller semicircle. So it's nothing but R2 equal to 7 centimeter, right? Now what we want to find? Area of the shaded region, right? Area of the shaded region we want to find. So area of shaded region is nothing but area of bigger semicircle plus, we are having two semicircles, right? Area of bigger semicircle plus a two times of area of smaller semicircle, right? So area of the shaded region is equal to, so area of shaded region is equal to area of bigger semicircle plus two times, because we are having two small semicircles, right? So two times of area of smaller semicircle. So what is the formula? Pi r 1 square divided by 2 plus 2 into pi r 2 square. R 2 is nothing but radius of smaller semicircle divided by 2. Already we know that sum of two semicircles is nothing but one circle. So by solving, we'll get the same thing only. Simplify, 2 cancel. You can substitute. What is it? What is the value of pi? Pi is nothing but 22 by 7 into 2. Already the 2 is there. So remember, the denominator I have written R1 square. What is R1? 14 centimeter. So into 14 plus, open the bracket, pi r2 square. Pi is nothing but 2 cancel here. So remaining what is that? Pi r2 square. Pi is nothing but 22 by 7 into, what is r2? 7. 7 into 7. 7 into 7. Simplify. 7 only 7. 7 2s are 14. 2 cancel. So remaining what is that? 22 into 14 plus 7 cancel. 22 into 14 is equal to 308 plus 22 into 7 is equal to 154. So 308 plus 154 is nothing but 462 centimeter square. Therefore, area of shaded region, right? Area of shaded region is equal to 462 centimeter square, right? Still we can see one more example and I will give you homework. So number 12, the given figure ABCD is a trapezium. ABCD is a trapezium with AB parallel to DC, and they have given the length AB is equal to 18 centimeter and DC is equal to, the length of DC is equal to 32 centimeter, and the distance between AB and DC is 14 centimeter, right? AB and DC is the distance. That is nothing but, this is a parallel line. That means the distance between AB and DC is nothing but height of the trapezium. Height of the trapezium is nothing but 14 centimeter. If arcs of equal radii, that means we are having four arcs in the trapezium, right? With equal radii, so all the radius are equal, right? All the radius of the four sectors are equal, right? All the equal, if arcs of equal radii, 7 centimeter with the centers A, B, C and D, right? A, B, C and D have been drawn. Then find the area of the shaded region, right? So first, how we are going to find the area of the shaded region? So I told you that we want to find the area of the total total figure, right? Area of total figure minus area of unshaded region, minus area of unshaded region. So area of total figure is nothing but area of a trapezium minus, right? Area of trapezium minus, here we are having sectors, four sectors with equal radii. That's very important, right? With equal radii, I'll give you one hint, one note you have to keep in your mind. Whenever we are having the same model, we have to apply that. We will see later, right? First we will see. So area of a trapezium minus 4 times of area of a sector. 4 times of area of a sector. But see, here we can't use 4 times of area of a sector because the angles are not equal. Only the radii alone will be equal. The angles are not equal. So what is it? Just area of trapezium minus area of the 4 sectors. While we are subtracting the area of 4 sectors, from the area of trapezium, we will get the area of the shaded region. We will get the area of the shaded region. So for finding the area of trapezium, first we want to know the formula. What is the formula for finding the area of trapezium? In 9th standard itself we have studied, but we can recall, area of trapezium is nothing but half into the sum of the length of two parallel sides, sum of the length of two parallel sides into height. Half into sum of, that is nothing but, simply I am saying that, half into sum of the parallel sides, that is nothing but AB, length of AB plus DC. AB plus DC into height. That is nothing but area of a trapezium formula, right? And one more hint, I told you that one more note we are having. First we will see that note. Before that we can write that what are the given and what we want to find. That first we will fill it. So what are the given we are having? So what are the shapes we are having, ma? Only trapezium alone. In the trapezium we are having sectors also. Trapezium and sectors. Trapezium and sectors. So in the trapezium what are the things we are having? AB is equal to 18 centimeter. AB is equal to 18 centimeter. DC is equal to 32 centimeter. And distance between AB and DC, it's a parallel. So the distance between AB and DC is nothing but height. Height of the trapezium is equal to 14 centimeter. Next, for sector, what are things we are having? For finding the area of a sector, what are things we are needed? Theta and radius, right? Theta and radius. But here radius alone they have given. So the equal radius for all the four sectors, the radius are equal. That is R is equal to 7 centimeter, right? R radius is nothing but 7 centimeter. They didn't give the value of theta. They didn't give the value of theta. So how we are going to find the theta? It's very simple. I will explain you. So what do you want to find? Area of shadow region, right? The theta is nothing but, right? Theta is nothing but angle, right? See here, already we know that the sum of the angle of a triangle is equal to, right? In a triangle, the sum of the angle of a triangle is equal to 180 degree, right? Theta 1 and this is theta 2, second angle, and this is third angle, theta 3, right? We are having three angles. The sum of three angle of a triangle is equal to, what is it? 180 degree. The sum of the three angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. The sum of the angles for the quadrilateral, right? How many angles are there for quadrilateral? We are having four angles, right? Theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 4. How many angles we are having? Four angles, right? Four angles. So how many angles? Four angles. That is nothing but the sum of the angle of a quadrilateral is nothing but how much? 360 degree. right? 360 degrees. So see, and this is very important note, just keep in your mind. See, very important note. See, if we are having a same radii, right, if we are having a same radii for all the four sectors, right, if we are having that, this is very important, if the radius should be same, then only if this note will be applicable, right. If we are having the same radii for the four sectors, right, then it is nothing but the area of the sum of the area of the four sector is nothing but pi r square, area of a circle, right, pi r square. So nothing but how it is coming means, right, is the area of a four sector, right, for a, in a quadrilateral, how many sectors we are having, four sector, and the, what is the condition, the all the four sectors, the radius of all the four sectors are equal, then sum of the area of the four sector, sum of the area of the four sector is equal to pi r square, right. How the pi r square came means, it's very simple, I will explain you separately, wait. Just we are going to find the area of these four sectors, right, area of four sector. So the radius for four sector, the radius are same, radius are equal, right, the radius are equal. And this is name a different angle, theta 1, this is theta 2, theta 3 and theta 4. So what is the formula for finding the area of a first sector? For area of a sector, anything but theta divided by 360 into pi r square, right? Theta divided by 360 into pi r square. So just to see that, I am just finding the area of a first sector. This is nothing but, I am taking as first sector, second sector, third sector, and this is fourth sector. So find the area of a first sector is nothing but theta 1 divided by 360 into pi r square plus theta 2, right? Theta 2 divided by 360 into pi r square, right? Plus adding the third sector, right? Theta 3 area of a sector, so theta 3 divided by 360 into pi r square plus fourth sector, area of fourth sector is theta 4 divided by 360 into pi r square, right. Just see the all the four sectors, all the four sectors, pi r square is common, just take commonly outside, and 360 also is common, right. So just take commonly outside, right. So what is the remaining? So pi r square divided by 360, I am just taking pi r square 360, I am just taking common term outside. So what is the remaining in the first term? Theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 4, right, we are having. So theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 4 is in the image, sum of 4 angle. What is the sum of 4 angle? See, theta 1 is in the image, this 4 angles, the 4 theta is nothing but angle of the four quadrilateral, 4 angles of a quadrilateral. Sum of the 4 angles of a quadrilateral is equal to how much? 360 degrees. So instead of this, shall I substitute 360? So 360 will get cancelled, right? Theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 4 is nothing but 360 degrees. The sum of the angle of the quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees. 360 cancel. So it is nothing but pi r square. Understood? So, you know, see, whenever we are having the same radii, right? Whenever we are having the same radii, then the area of the sum of the area of the four sector in a quadrilateral is nothing but pi r square. Right. Next, in a triangle, right? In a triangle, we are having three sectors, right? We are having three sectors. A, B, C is a triangle. And now we are having three sectors, right? Three sectors with the same radii. Then the sum of the area of the three sectors in a triangle is equal to pi r square by 2. How means? Very simple, the same methodology. Here we are having three angles, right? Theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3, right? So this is the common thing. So what is it? Pi r square divided by 360 degree, right? Pi r square divided by 360 degree into three angles we are having. Theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. Three angles. What is the sum of the three angles of a triangle? 180 degree. So instead of this, shall I substitute 180 degree? Simplify 180 degree one times, two times. So it is nothing but pi r square divided by 2. Therefore, just note down the note. This is a very important note. Right? The sum of the area of the four sectors in a quadrilateral is nothing but pi r square. The sum of the area of the sectors in a triangle is equal to pi r square by 2, right? You can take it as a note, and wherever it is needed, you can apply directly, right? You don't want to spend this much of time, right? Separately, you want to write, and for each one R pi value substitute and you are simplifying means it will take so much time. Directly you can write it, no problem, right? Understood? Now we can see that sum of the area of the four sectors in coordinate is equal to pi r square. Sum of the area of three sectors in a triangle is equal to pi r square by 2, right? Now you can go for area of shadow region. Area of shadow region is equal to what is it? Area of trapezium minus area of four sectors, right? Minus area of four sectors. Directly shall I substitute and simplify? Area of shadow region is equal to area of trapezium, right? Area of trapezium minus area of finding the area of trapezium minus area of four sectors in quadrilateral. Area of four sectors. So what is the formula of area of trapezium? I told you that half into sum of the parallel sides. Here sum of the parallel sides is in the image. AB plus DC, right? AB plus DC into height minus area of four sector. Shall I write directly? Area of four sector is nothing but pi r square, right? Area of four sector in quadrilateral is equal to, right? In a quadrilateral is equal to pi r square, right? Now substitute the value. We know that half AB value DC H as well as R value also. Substitute and simplify. Directly we can find it. So half into, open the bracket, half into AB. What is the length of AB? 18 centimeter. 18 plus DC is nothing but 32 into 14. Height is nothing but 14 centimeter. Close the bracket, minus, open the bracket, pi value 22 by 7 into R value 7 centimeter. 7 into 7, right? Simplify to 1 times 7 times 7, 7 cancel. So remaining what is there? First we want to add and then only we want to multiply. 18 plus 32, 50. So 50 into 7, right? 50 into 7 minus 22 into 7. Simplify. 50 into 7, how much? 350 minus 22 into 7 is equal to 154. So if we are subtracting 350 minus 154, we will get 196 centimeter square. Therefore, area of shadow region is equal to 196 centimeter square. Right? Today these two sums is enough. You can take one sum as a homework, right? So number 13, an athletic track. Athletic track. See, this is the athletic track. Inside there is something about some ground, right? Only this is nothing but track. Shadow region is called as a track, right? An athletic track 14 meter wide. That is nothing but 14 meter wide. So this is nothing but wide, right? 14 meter. How much? 14 meter wide. Breadth or width. 14 meter wide. Consists of two straight sections. These are the A, B and C, D is nothing but two straight sections. 150 meter long. How much long? 150 meter long. Joining semicircular ends whose inner radius is nothing but 28 meter. Whose inner radius is nothing but 28 meter, right? Whose inner radius is nothing but, I will taking as O. So adjust it. The inner radius, the small circle is nothing but 28 meter. Calculate the area of the shadow region. So how we want to find? The final answer is nothing but area 7080 meter square. So how we want to find? A very simple area of shadow region. It's nothing but, see, this is nothing but how it will be. Rectangle, right? How it will be? Rectangle. So area, we are having two rectangles. And this is nothing but how it will be. Ring, right? Area of a ring. How many rings are there? Two rings are there. And how many rectangles are there? Two rectangles. For finding the area of rectangle, what are things we are needed? Length and breadth. Length is 150 meter and breadth is nothing but 14 meter. So we are having a length and breadth for finding the area of rectangle. For finding the area of a ring, what are things we are needed? Capital R and small r. Big radius and small radius. Small radius they have given 28 meter. How you will find a big radius, capital R. How you will find a capital R? So small r plus width. Already we know the width. width of the track. So small r plus width is equal to capital R. So we'll adding that. So 2 times of area of rectangle plus 2 times of area of a ring. By using that formula, we can find the area. And today only one sum is enough. And tomorrow we can see the remaining sums. Thank you.